There is a debate in the Linux community that asks the question, which is better for new users, rolling releases or stable releases? And there have been a couple of videos recently asking this question or giving opinions on this matter. And I thought I would throw my hat in the ring because, frankly, the two videos that came out, they kind of are both wrong and they're both right. So let me show you the videos I'm talking about and then I'll give you my opinion. The first video is this video from DT where he suggests that we should stop recommending stable distros to new users and we should instead recommend things like Manjaro and Arch and Arch-based distros for new users. It was a short video, just a minute long, and he expresses his opinion that new users should use things like Arch and Arch-based distros. He specifically mentions Manjaro, Arco, Endeavor, and things like that. And then the day after, Brody Robertson did this one here, where he talked about stable versus rolling releases and which one is better for new users. And he suggested that most new users should use stable releases unless they're technologically inclined. And the two videos here kind of straddle the line of being right and wrong. Because the answer to this question isn't which one is better for new users, it's which one's better for you. Because every new user is completely different. Everyone has a different level of technical expertise that they can bring to the table. Frankly, I think that if you can burn an ISO, you probably can use whatever distro you want, because the vast majority of them are fairly easy, and the ones that are harder are very well documented. So if you can burn an ISO, you probably can even install Arch Linux because the documentation is really good. Should you use Arch Linux, even if you have that small level of expertise? I don't know. It depends on the rest of your ability to learn and look things up. If you're installing Linux on your mother's machine or a person who doesn't have technical expertise, then actually going through and installing Arch or an Arch-based distro doesn't make a ton of sense. Now, I don't think that you would go wrong by installing something like Manjaro on someone else's machine, even if they don't have technical expertise, because, or at least that would be the case as long as you're willing to do the maintenance for it. If you're counting on someone else to do the maintenance, then it's obviously a problem. If you're installing it and you're the noob, then you really have to be able to examine your own level of expertise in order to decide which one's better for you. And this is where we become with a problem, because the Linux community does not do a good job of pointing you towards the right area for you. There's a ton of information out there. There are a ton of different distros, and it can be really overwhelming if you don't know what Linux is or how to install Linux or what the difference even is between stable and rolling. And while you can find the answers to those questions, once you get past the definition of them and trying to figure out which one is better for you, it becomes much more murky because you're going to have two different opinions from 1,000 different YouTubers. They all have different opinions and they're all right and they're all wrong. The best solution for you is to try it. If you can go through and install whatever distribution looks the best to you, try to install it. If it works, that's great. If it doesn't work, try a different distro. There are plenty to choose from. That's the best way to learn. It's the best way to find which one is best for you, because to be honest, no one can answer that question for you. You have to be able to experiment. That's the Linux way. Every single person who gets into Linux starts out basically the same way. They find a distro that has been recommended to them or has been installed for them or some, however they get into Linux. Then they go through and they use it for a little while and they experiment with that distro. Maybe they find something that's wrong with it or something and they decide to hop. They decide to distro hop. That's where the term comes from. And almost every single person hops for quite a while after they switch to Linux because they have to experience the different distros. They have to experience the different package management systems like Pacman and apt and RPMs and all this kind of stuff. They have to learn how to install snaps and flatpaks. And they have to discover which desktop environments are the best for them. That's the best way to learn Linux. It's the best way to find out which Linux distribution is best for you. And that's the only way. It doesn't matter what any YouTuber tells you which one is better. They can't answer that question for you. It has to be you. Now, you can make an informed decision based on research on the internet, but don't let one person's opinion on which kind of release is better for you sway you. Try them both. Set aside a hard drive, or set aside a machine, a laptop, or whatever, and just install one, use it for a while. If it doesn't work, or if it crashes, or is too unstable, or you can't get it installed, move on to the next one. That's the way Linux works. So, just a short little video. I'm going to cut this off here because it's storming and raining and all that stuff outside. I'm worried about the electricity. So thank you for watching. You can follow me on Twitter at TheLinuxCast. You can support me on Patreon at patreon.com/LinuxCast. Before I go, I'd like to take a moment to thank my current patrons. Devon Chris, East Coast Web, Gentoo is Fun 2, Marcus, Meglin, Donnie, Sven, Jackson Knife and Tool, Mitchell, Mr. Fox, Art Center, American Camp. Thanks everybody for watching. I'll see you next time.